All right, to get started, I just added a couple clips to my timeline. Now, first, if you just want to resize every video in your entire sequence, go up to Sequence and select Sequence Settings. For the frame size, type your video's resolution. Mine's 1920 by 1012, so that's what I'll put. Then just hit OK. Okay, and there my video fits in the frame, but obviously this won't work if you have different resolutions on your timeline, so let's talk about resizing an individual video. The easiest way to get rid of the black space on an individual video is to right-click your clip on the timeline and select Set to Frame Size. Okay, most of the time this'll work, but if you don't have a 16:9 aspect ratio like me, you might be left with some black on the sides or bottom. The quickest way to manually change the size of your video is to double-click it in the preview to view its handles. Then, drag any of the handles to resize the video. And to change the video's position, just drag the actual video once you see the handles. Now, if you want to more precisely change the size of a video, first make sure your clip is selected on the timeline, and then go over to Effect Controls. In here, you can select the scale's value, which will let you type in your desired scale and resize it. You can also click on its value and drag it to the left or right to resize it that way. If you want to stretch out your video, since as you can see, increasing the scale can crop some of it out, uncheck the Uniform Scale checkbox. Now, when you drag the handles, it'll stretch your video instead of adjusting the scale proportionately. Just be aware that when you stretch your video, it may impact the quality, so don't do it too much. Lastly, I'll just mention that there's an option to rotate your video as well, but I usually don't use this and save that for images. Okay, and that's it for this tutorial, so as always, thanks for watching and see you next time.